All right, and that's promised. Right back into episode two, and picking right up at the common room, my bedroom. Dorm. Bedroom? Suite. Right where we left off at. And so let's go out here and we'll start talking to my fellow classmates.
I suppose some introductions are in order.
Indeed.
That is not helpful.
I recognize you. You are someone I talked to in the other playthroughs.
Can I help you? Oh, you're the new fifth year. I'm Sebastian Sallow. Welcome to Slytherin.
Thank you.
Not everyone has a ministry escort to school.
He was a friend of Professor Figg's who merely joined us for the ride.
Still, impressive. Dreadful way to go, poor fellow. Glad you and Figg are all right.
It was quite exciting.
It was dreadful, certainly, but quite an experience nonetheless.
Interesting perspective. How did you and Figg manage to escape?
It's all still a bit of a blur, to be honest.
Didn't mean to press. You just get yourself settled. We can talk more later.
Yeah, what were you reading?
What book were you reading?
A spellbook I picked up. Has a few interesting things, but not exactly what I was looking for. I'm sure you'll find out soon enough, but not every spell you may need can be found in our assigned textbooks.
Intriguing. Ooh, what do you mean?
Are you saying some spells aren't taught at Hogwarts? Which ones?
I can imagine.
Seems I may have met a kindred spirit. That is a convers... It was good meeting you. Good luck today.
There's that audio hiccups I was referring to once again. I wonder if consoles have the same problem. I do know that this was made for consoles and ported to PC. So I'll be intrigued to know if consoles also have these audio hiccups.
Ugh, not going to move there, are you?
Here, watch this.
Don't say I didn't warn you. Checkmate. Told you. They should have listened to me. Ah, I know who you are. You're the new Slytherin, the one who barged in with Professor Figg last night. Interesting tactic on your first day, taking all the attention away from the first years. I'm Imelda, by the way. Shame I wasn't with you and Figg. I could have lured that dragon away. My skills on a broom are legendary.
Too bad a dragon is faster than a broom.
We handled it. And I think you're underestimating the nature of a dragon. A broom would have been kindling.
Yeah.
Not the way I fly. Perhaps one of these days I'll show you a thing or two about flying. I can teach you more than Kagawa ever could. Speaking of which, I'd like to get in some time on my broom before classes.
Are you a keen wizard chess fan? You knew that boy was going to lose the match.
Not really. Much too sedate a pastime for me. Also, it's simply not that challenging. The moves are always so obvious. Why does no one else see it?
You know, inside like that, you could have been a Ravenclaw. I don't care if she flies a lot or not.
Goodbye, Imelda.
Nice meeting you.
Now, Harry was barely able to outfly that dragon on his Firebolt, which is the fastest broom at that point to ever been made, and that was 200 years after now. So, I don't think she would have stood a chance.
I think I heard one.
Doubt mermaids find us that interesting. Ah, based on all the chatter when you entered the common room, I'm guessing you're the new fifth year. I'm Ominous. Ominous Gaunt.
Are you blind?
Nice to meet you, Ominous.
Well, you certainly had a memorable arrival.
Oh, shit, wrong one.
I'd much rather have arrived on time and without a dragon attack en route.
I'm sure. How horrible. I can only imagine. Well, it's good to have you in Slytherin. Do let me know if I can be of any help as you navigate your first days here.
Were you expecting to be sorted into Slytherin?
Most certainly. My family on my father's side are direct descendants of Salazar Slytherin, one of the four founders of Hogwarts. Not something I'm especially proud of, mind you. He was obsessed with blood status, a pure-blood maniac. Unfortunately, most of his descendants do not fall far from that tree.
Except for you, I guess?
Did that student say he thought he heard a mermaid?
Yes, but I've never heard of a mermaid showing up outside our common room window. It is fun to play along, though. Been known to keep some first years on the lookout for hours.
Thank you, Ominous. Very nice to meet you.
Pleasure was all mine. Don't be a stranger.
I'm assuming
the new fifth year Slytherin in here. Professor Weasley's waiting for you just by the stairs.
I'm going to assume, by the way, he was talking about looking at me, he's blind. Which is weird that you think with all the magical fixes, they have in Harry Potter, that they would have one to cure blindness. But then again, wizards still wear glasses, because apparently they can't fix that, so I guess eyesight's something they cannot fix. Does anyone else find it weird that they do have a lot of magic? They can literally grow bones! Grow bones! They even have a potion for baldness, which is how the Potters made their money. So, why can't they fix eyesight?
Good morning. I trust you're ready for your first day at Hogwarts?
I've been dreaming of this day for a long time. Can't believe I'm here.
Well, you are here. Make the most of it. You only have one first day at Hogwarts. Now, in light of your unique situation, joining us as a fifth year, you'll need to catch up with your classmates and not fall behind. Especially as you'll be expected to complete your OWLs at the end of the year.
OWLs? OWLs?
Yes, your ordinary wizarding level exams. They will determine what type of career you can have when you leave here. After much discussion with the headmaster and the Department of Magical Education at the Ministry, we've devised something extraordinary to ensure your success. Here you are.
I feel like this book should be standard issue for every student.
What is it?
It is a wizard's field guide. It will help you to keep track of what you are learning so that you master all that's expected of a fifth year. You would be wise to take full advantage of this exceptionally valuable resource.
I like their pockets.
Thank you, Professor, but what do you mean it will keep track of what I'm learning?
Perhaps seeing it in action will answer any questions you may have. Walk with me and we shall put it to the test.
By the way, for anyone who hasn't started playing this yet, Revelio is your friend. Like, spam that thing.
I would have appreciated something like the field guide when I was a student. Using the guide will also train you to be alert to your surroundings. The guide will give you opportunities to practice your magic and educate yourself about wizarding lore. Do keep up.
Revelio.
Why don't you cast Revelio on that statue?
Kelpie statue. This statue depicts the Kelpie, a shape-shifting water demon native to Ireland and Great Britain, which usually takes the form of a long-maned horse. The largest Kelpie ever reported is the Loch Ness Monster in Scotland. That's simply telling you that the guide challenges are the only way to gain XP. So you cannot just farm bad guys.
Clever, isn't it? Keep your eyes open for more opportunities like that, inside and outside of the castle.
I absolutely love exploring in this game anyway, but it's also a good way to get ahead on levels. And I'll also go ahead and show you a couple of the more puzzle-oriented challenges that I figured out, and I'll show you how to beat those. Took me hours on my offline
timing. Account. Perfect opportunity to show you how to use flu flames to get around a bit quicker. Your field guide contains a map of the castle. Open it up and find Central Hall.
I'd be intrigued to know what happened to this network between now and the events of Harry Potter. Yeah, I just... There you go. So I'm recording this one like immediately after episode one. So I'm still a little tired and sore from work.
Quite the time saver. These stairs lead directly to Central Hall. You can get almost anywhere in the castle quickly from Central Hall. Always something happening here. It's the heart of the hive. Our King's Cross Station, so to speak. That should be all for now. You'll be expected to attend both Charms and Defense Against the Dark Arts classes today. And I'd like to be sure you get to Hogsmeade as soon as possible to replace the supplies you lost on the way here.
Thank you, Professor Weasley.
A lot to absorb on your first day.
Oh, man.
And you have much to learn. Happily, your professors have agreed to create additional assignments for you outside of class. You'll be up to speed in no time. Judging by your adept use of Revelio earlier, I'd say Professor Fig succeeded in at least showing you the basics.
He did, Professor.
He's been terribly vague as to the events preceding your arrival, specifically about what happened after that awful dragon attack. My suspicion is that there's more to the story than a search for belongings and an extended trip up to the castle.
I'm sorry, Professor, but I'm afraid that's all there is to it.
Almost precisely what Professor Fig said. Speak of the devil, Professor Fig. Your ears must have been burning.
Oh?
Yes. You seem to have provided our new fifth year with a solid foundation in the basics of spellcasting.
Ah, I'm afraid I can't take all the credit there, Professor. They've a rare aptitude for magic, it seems.
Well, I'm just glad you both arrived in one piece. Perfectly good boats and carriages to Hogwarts, and you chose to fly in the path of a dragon.
I wouldn't say I chose the dragon's path, Professor. Rather unfortunately, it would seem that it chose us.
Very well. Enough chit-chat. I need to get to class myself. Might I rely on you, Professor Fig, to explain the details of the field guide's map?
Of course.
Thank you. Good luck today. And remember to use your field guide. It will be invaluable to you. And invaluable to me. As I'll be using it to keep up to date on your progress.
Yes, Professor.
Come and find me in my classroom after you've attended both classes today, and I'll explain more about those assignments I mentioned. And we'll see if we can't get you to Hogsmeade for those supplies.
In my wand. I want my own wand.
It's good to see you, Professor.
And you. I was hoping our paths would cross today before you immersed yourself in studies. Did I hear you masterfully evade Professor Weasley's interrogation regarding our late arrival?
I did my best, but I'm fairly certain she suspects that we're not being entirely forthcoming.
Fairly certain.
Well, Professor Weasley is a brilliant and astute witch. It was right to keep the details to yourself for now. We don't know where this path we've embarked upon will lead. It may require a bit more flexibility with your time than she would approve of, and she may feel obliged to share details with the headmaster that would be better left between us.
Understood, Professor.
Good. Now, as capable as you are, I believe the ability you possess obliges you to be well-trained.
Indeed.
Happily, you have the benefit of an exceptionally skilled team of witches and wizards to guide you. Speaking of guides, and so that I may avoid another not-so-subtle reproof from Professor Weasley, why don't I show you the clever enchantment we included in the field guide's map? Unfold it and have a look.
I do rather enjoy this. Isn't that what I needed to do? Oh, you want me to hit? I don't know why I needed. You want me to do that for? It is simply telling you that by clicking on the gold shields, you can track your quests.
The map is enchanted to help you find your way.
This will be incredibly helpful. Thank you.
Now, sounds like you've quite a day ahead, what with classes and a trip to Hogsmeade for supplies, including your own wand. You'll enjoy Mr. Ollivander. He's an exceptional craftsman and a good friend. I shall reach out when I have more information about our mysterious locket. For now, focus on your classes and pay attention. More than your owls may hinge on the magic you are able to master within these walls.
Like my rise to power. So, since I'm already here, and I know there's one around here, I thought there was one around here. The other side? Might be the other side.
This cannot possibly be.
Revelio.
Yep, there we go. There's that. I'll go ahead and grab that. Central Hall Fountain. This ornate fountain features intricately carved statues of denizens of the magical world, including a set of stone sirens encircling the fountain's base. Cannot get the flapping page until I get the Accio spell. I want to go ahead and show you guys this door, because I know a lot of people struggle with this door, and honestly, there's actually one upstairs in like an attic area that kind of, they do their best to guide you through how they want this done. It took me a while to figure it out myself, but since this is here, I'm going to go ahead and show you how this works. So first of all, reveal. Now, the middle number is important, actually target number. The outer circles, they want you to add. And each of these symbols represents a number. And you can find a parchment. There's a parchment in the upstairs door. It tells you what the numbers are. Or you can simply remember 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It's on the door. And if you ever get lost, just count the prominent things. So Hydra has 9 heads. Spider has 8 legs. The octopus is supposed to have 7 tentacles. I'm not too sure what the counting on that lizard. Maybe the spines, it has 6 spines on its frill around its head. That creature has 5 legs. I'm not too sure what the bird has, the fooper. 3-headed Hydra. I think it's supposed to be a dragon, has 2 horns, the unicorn has 1 horn, and once again, I'm not too sure what that is, but it's supposed to have nothing, probably no tusk or horns or anything. So, with that knowledge, that dragon thing has 2 horns, that's 11, plus 2 is 13. We want to get to 21. So, obviously to get to 21, you need 8 more. And you're going to take that 8 being that spider. Here, come over here to the single question mark, and you're gonna find the 8-legged spider. So 11 plus 8 plus 3 is 21. Double question marks. Number 17. Nidra has 9 heads. 9. 5-legged creature. 5. 9, 5 is 14. Which means you need 3. You look over here. 0, 1, 2, 3. 3-headed Hydra. So you're gonna find the double question mark. Dice.
Revelio.
I forget where that's at. I think it's up here. Yeah, it's up there. Okay. And you're going to activate this until you come across the 3-headed Hydra. So you have 9 and 5 and 3. 17. Open the door. That's it. That's all there is to it. That's how you open those doors. And every door will work the same way. they won't have the same puzzle, but the puzzle's worked out in the same way. Now another one. The other one, it didn't take me nearly as long as that door did.
There's something in there. I just know it.
Hello. I don't believe we've met.
Oh, hello. I'm Lenora. Pardon me if I seem a little distracted at the moment. Everyone thinks I'm utterly balmy. Samantha thinks I'm potty. But it's this painting. I never noticed it before. If I know Hogwarts, and I do, an empty frame doesn't appear for no reason. There's something more to this.
It's Hogwarts. There's always something more. I didn't mean to skip over, while I was talking to Professor Weasley. I didn't mean to skip over these. I want to click on these so you guys can see them.
Are there any other empty paintings like this around the school?
Yes, a few. This entire place is somewhat of a riddle, to be honest. If I can work out the riddle of this one, I'll know what to do with all of them. As good a place as any to begin.
Have you gained any insights about the painting since you've been studying it?
I did discover that casting Lumos has an effect of some kind. But I'm not sure what to do next.
If I have the time, I may look. Could be intriguing.
I've been racking my brains long enough. I hope you'll have better luck than I have.
So, obviously, cast Lumos.
That spot must be a clue.
Indeed.
I should look around in case it's nearby.
And they normally are. And obviously, okay, most everyone knows this, you know, find the location. And
this
there's the moth.
Like the location from the painting.
Yeah. I tried everything in the world, except for the most obvious.
Let's get you back to your frame, little moth.
Now, granted, when I accepted this quest the first time, I already had like 4 or 5 spells at my disposal. And I tried every spell at my disposal except Lumos. And you come over here, you turn off Lumos.
I knew there was a connection.
Settled into the painting.
I should tell Lenora that I solved the puzzle of that empty frame.
And you collect your little XP. Remember, you need to do these challenges to get XP. You get XP for the challenges and for completing quests. You don't get XP for defeating monsters. There is no killing monsters gain XP.
Lenora, I solved the mystery of that painting.
You did? How?
And once again, my guy's an asshole.
I'm afraid I can't tell you, Lenora.
Surely you jest!
You should have worked it out on your own.
You have nerve. Especially since I'm the one who told you about it in the first place. Imagine solving a riddle that I mentioned, and then...
Nothing stopping you from doing it on your own.
See who's a more infuriating know-it-all.
Oh. Yeah. That does tend to happen from time to time, those little hiccups. It's never been long. It's usually for a second or two. Once again, I can get that page whenever I learn Accio. And for those who don't know, there is a little...
I've always said that this way? Travel broadens
on the other side.
Rebellion.
Oh, yep. Once again, always be on the lookout for those. Oh, hang on. I will pull it up. Meant to read it to you guys. And it's under collections. Quests. Exploration. Huh. I haven't found that yet. It's already given me credit for it. Oh well. It's not there. Is it here? It is here. Here we go. This statue with an ingratiating grin depicts the medieval wizard Gregory the Smarmy.
Hang on.
Okay, I will edit out that massive time skip. I know you guys will have seen the jump in the time. You missed nothing, I promise. My mom called, and she just wanted to talk. And yeah, things are going on right now, and I'll take every opportunity to talk to her. Anyway, what was he doing? Oh yeah, I was reading this statue for you guys. This statue with an ingratiating grin depicts the medieval wizard Gregory the Smarmy, the wizard famous for inventing Gregory's Unctuous Unction, a potion that makes the drinker believe whoever gave them the potion is their best friend. Okay. Now, let's try to remember what I was doing outside of here. I'm pretty sure I showed y'all the door. Yep, that's open. I'm pretty sure I showed you the mirror painting. Yep, that's gone. Alright, so I think I just wanted to spend some time going around and just explore a little bit, get some XPs.
Revelio.
Kind of weird. I wonder. I keep hearing these voices. I wonder if this is supposed to be an Easter egg in reference to the Chamber of Secrets. And
Revelio.
Oh, not what I meant to do. I will take that though. Memorandum, date 31st of December, 1875, from Orr Office. Subject, Morgan and Burks. Morgan and Burks has had an increased amount of activity outside of the ordinary shop hours, particularly in the wee hours of the night with suspicious deliveries being made to the shop's back entrance. Given what we know of the shop's reputation, we are adding more Orrs to join those that have already been watching the shop. You're amongst the new additions. Further instructions to follow. I do believe it is stated that Professor Sharp, the potions professor, is a former Orr. Why he would have a letter like that just hanging about in his office, I don't know. Maybe because he just wouldn't expect a student to just randomly burge into his office.
Rebellion.
And anything in here? I heard the ding. It's just weird that it's going off, but nothing is really... Ah, there it is. Professor Sharp's Aura Badge. Auras comprise the Ministry's magical law enforcement and protect the wizarding world from all sorts of threats. Particularly those posed by dark magic, this Aura Badge belongs to Professor Sharp. I'd be proud of that badge too. Honestly, I'm not too sure how much time has passed. I was keeping track of it on my phone, how much time I had spent recording, so I didn't play for too long. But the phone call from my mother kind of threw me off. I'm not too sure how much time I spent on the phone. So I'm not going to spend actually as much time exploring as I would have wanted to originally. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and just knock out these two classes and call it a stream from there. And I'll...
Handy resource indeed, your
there
field
something
guide.
Else too.
I'm most pleased.
A dash of
rebellion. And I'll find out after editing how long the episode was. And if the episode was too short, I will apologize. And there's that hiccup. There you go. May I actually give you guys time to tell me whether or not you actually are interested in watching me do all this explorizing, or if you just want me to get on with the story. This painting depicts the young orphan wizard Ilias, who famously saved his entire village from an army of Dementors and the dark wizard Raxidian by conjuring a mouse Patronus. I'm not sure how a mouse Patronus saves you from a dark wizard.
You scoundrel!
I do not pay for all your school things to be rewarded with a house full of hexes.
Ooh.
Your father's in St. Mungo's to get his horns removed, and it's taken the house elf a week to unstick that screaming portrait. A week! You will behave, or so help me Merlin, I will bring you straight back home.
Got a howler in the middle of school. That's embarrassing. And defense against dark arts. Well, I'll learn the Levioso spell.
Is that all you've got?
Yeah.
Professor Hecate!
Perhaps you'd be good enough to blast each other to pieces on your own time. I get new students every year, but I only have one Hebridean black skull. It was a token from the great poacher raid of 1870.
So, I guess the game kind of crashed out, but I kind of skipped that whole cutscene, which is weird. That's the first time it's ever happened. And I'm not too sure. I've lost my mouse too.
Levioso.
Now, let's try something a little larger.
That is really, really weird. I mean, I don't think my recording did that. I mean, I spent 12 days, 12 hours streaming Tuesday and didn't have that kind of problem.
See how the dummy deflected your cast? This time, cast Levioso first, then the basic cast.
Levioso.
A surprise.
Good. Ow.
Now, the basic cast. Well done.
Huh.
Very good. But the best way to practice is by dueling. We'll start with you two. Duelist, take your marks.
Time for a proper Hogwarts welcome.
Now, I want a fair duel, using only Levioso, basic cast. And you may begin.
Come on.
Levioso. This can't be your first duel. Let's just say I'm a quick learner.
Stupid.
Levioso.
I do enjoy a lively duel. Watch your opponent for
signs. Do you surrender
or defend yourself?
Not bad for a beginner. You give as good as you get.
Had a little out of classroom experience.
I put you on the spot, and you rose to the challenge. Points to Slytherin.
Thank you, Professor Hecate. Glad to have the opportunity to practice.
If what I've seen today is any indication, we can expect great things from you. I demand excellence from my students. They are capable of achieving it, and they must achieve it. A classroom duel is one thing, but battling dark wizards, or as ever more likely, goblins, is a different kettle of Grindelows entirely.
Understood, Professor.
So, I'd advise you to keep practicing whenever you can. Perhaps Mr. Sallow will have some ideas for you. Again, well done today. I shall reach out soon with additional assignments.
Why would you have a kettle of Grindelows?
That's enough spectacle for one day. Class is dismissed.
Nice work.
I enjoyed that.
Well, that duel was quite something. Everyone will be talking about it.
It was certainly good practice.
Practice? Felt more like I was dueling an expert. didn't expect a new student to be so deft with a wand. Then again, perhaps this wasn't your first duel.
Nah.
I've dueled enough. Consider yourself lucky I held back.
Huh, fair enough. You owe me an honest duel when you aren't. You know, you might be a perfect fit for a certain exclusive, unsanctioned dueling organization.
Exclusive and unsanctioned. Count me in.
Excellent. Knew I was right about you. If you want to get the most out of your time at Hogwarts, you're going to need to break the rules now and then. Whether it's joining a secret dueling club, or sneaking into the restricted section of the library, you just have to be clever enough not to get caught.
Thank you, Sebastian. I'll keep that in mind.
Good. Pleasure chatting with you. I'm sure I'll see you soon. Perhaps somewhere unsanctioned? We'll see if your performance today was sheer luck or actual skill. Look for Luke and Brattleby near the clock tower entrance, if you're interested.
I like how he talks about his unsanctioned club. I'm like just mere yards away from the professor. But then again, she already knows about it, or else she wouldn't have sent me over here to talk about it. Where am I going? Yeah, I'm going the right way. Alright. Off to my charms class. So we can call this an episode. And we can... we'll see how things go after these first two episodes. That's Eddie Cleaver being chased by his, I guess, wife in the afterlife. Yep.
Professor Ronan tends to go on a bit. We sometimes have to remind him to finish the lesson.
Anyways. But we'll see how this goes, how you guys like these episodes, and how much of it you actually want to see.
Here. Behind you. There is an open seat here.
Thank you.
Hello, I am Nettie. So you are the new student. Have you met Professor Ronan yet?
Shall we begin? Welcome to year 5 of charms. Now, this will be a crucial year in your education on the art of charm work, but I am confident that we will take hold with a passion and rigor requisite of such a challenge. Right, now, everyone, please open your textbooks to page 517. But before we begin, can anyone here tell me the difference between the incantations of the color change and growth charms? Anyone? Anyone? I am afraid it is too late to study now. My, the summer months must have really taken a toll on you all. By the looks of it, you all spent your holidays practicing Obliviate on one another. Do you even remember how to perform a basic summoning charm? Well, it seems that we are in dire need of review. Everyone get into pairs and take positions on opposite sides of the classroom. Now let's put those textbooks to use as the blunt objects you so believe they are, and take turns summoning them out of one another's hands. Only one book will be needed per partnership, Miss Dale. Thank you. Get into place now.
I mean, in all fairness, this is my character's first time at Hogwarts. And I'm glad my cursor's back now. Still trying to figure out what went wrong with all that.
That is not bad.
You are a swift learner. I see a lot of potential, but remember, potential is nothing without practice. Keep at it. You might just rival Miss Onai here. Very good, everyone. That's enough of that. Well, as you all seem to have the basics down, and it is an exceptionally lovely day, I was thinking that we might have ourselves a little excursion outside for a spot of fresh air. After me.
Well, certainly after you. I would hope the students would follow you.
I've always found that fun goes hand in hand with mastery, as I'm sure the Quidditch players amongst us would agree, So, what better than a bit of sport to put our prowess with the summoning charm to the test, right?
Right.
So why don't we have our newest student start us off?
All right. Let's go.
Cast Accio on one. That's it. Now, think of this like goldstones, if you will. But instead of... Splendid!
A little short. Oh, well.
Very good! Points to Slytherin! Woo-hoo. But there's certainly no sport in playing without some friendly competition. Miss Onai, would you care to give our new student a bit of a challenge? Come on up!
Let's put the new kid versus the top student of the class.
Miss Onai, you are playing red. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Let us do this.
Excellent control there.
What's this?
Let's go.
Ouch! Well played. Be sharp.
GG!
That is how it's done.
What was that?
A perfect score. Remarkable. Let us make this a bit more interesting, shall we?
I had a random GG go off in my ear. I shouldn't be streaming.
I think we are well past interesting at this point.
I'll say.
Enough chatter. Focus now. You will need it. This round settles it all.
Let us see this.
Okay. I'm not streaming. There was a random soundboard that went off in my ear, and I have no idea what it was.
Very good.
What? Yes.
Let's see. And 50.
Quite impressive. Here we go. That is how it's done.
Let's go right here.
Accio.
Do not fall off. There we go. Yeah.
That's it.
Not bad for the future overlord.
Very good, both of you. Well done. Class is dismissed. Gather your things on the way out.
Good game back there. I must admit, I think I underestimated you. Took me weeks to become proficient with Accio. Took weeks for me to get anything right when I transferred here. It gets easier, I promise.
Thank you, but I've been holding my own.
I appreciate your confidence. I transferred here from Ouagadougou just before my fourth year. My mother received an offer to teach divination here. Before I knew it, we had left Uganda and were halfway around the world at a new school in a new country.
I love her accent. Ordinarily, this guy wouldn't give a damn, but I want you guys to hear this stuff, so I will play through it.
Is Ouagadougou much bigger than Hogwarts?
Ouagadougou School of Magic is the largest wizarding school in the world. So yes, bigger than Hogwarts. But it never seemed intimidating or overwhelming to me. It always felt like home.
Is Ouagadougou a castle, like Hogwarts?
Its address is Mountains of the Moon. It is not so much a castle as a beautiful edifice carved out of the mountainside. I remember the first time I saw it, the mist was so thick I could hardly make out anything at all. And then it just materialized before me, this enormous school that seemed to be floating in midair.
This may seem an odd question, but is magic the same there as it is here?
Mostly, yes. But I did have to learn how to use a wand when I arrived here. Hardly anyone at Ouagadougou uses one.
Spells cast without a wand must be less powerful than those cast with a wand.
No, not at all. Wizarding magic cast without a wand is just as powerful. I find wandless magic to be much more instinctive, not to mention quite convenient if one is without their wand. I must admit, however, that I am growing quite fond of using a wand. It seems very dramatic.
It's nice to learn about another wizarding school.
Thank you for asking. I do miss Ouagadougou, but I am glad to be here at Hogwarts. Ah, I think Professor Ronan wants to talk to you. Better not keep him waiting. Until next time.
Of course, you can use Accio on humans, if you're so inclined.
Well, you'd be using it on clothing to be
precise,
Vespi.
If you would.
You know it won't work on humans.
I just want to point out that wand magic, just from logic, sense of the way lore works in Harry Potter, would be more powerful than wandless magic. There wouldn't be such an emphasis on finding a wand that matches the wand user. Like, it's stated that, you know, my character's magic would be stronger with the wand that, sorry, I had a tech machine to check. But your magic would be more powerful with a wand that's chosen for you, or a wand that chooses you, as opposed to a wand that's borrowed. And there wouldn't be such a need to separate a wizard from their wand if it really made a difference. We have seen wizards use magic without wands, and the magic is indeed not as powerful. Unless you're going to sit there and tell me that Dumbledore, the most powerful wizard in the world, just didn't know how to do wandless magic. Like, the Elder, like, Voldemort's power increased dramatically with the use of the Elder Wand. even though it wasn't a wand that was under his control. He was still more powerful with it than he was with any other wand. So wands are obviously a magic multiplier.
You wanted to speak with me, Professor?
I did. I trust your first charms lesson lived up to expectation?
Well, an outdoor competition wasn't exactly the lesson I was expecting, sir.
What charm is there in the expected? You did well, managing to best as gifted a student as Miss Onai.
Thank you, Professor. I enjoyed the match.
Miss Onai is always a fierce competitor, though I sense that she is a bit distracted of late. Now, Professor Weasley has asked that your professors give you instruction outside of the ordinary curriculum. Expect to hear from me soon regarding a special assignment that I am preparing for you.
All right. This is where I'm going to leave episode 2 at. Once again, please let me know in the comment section what you want.
You're the new student, aren't you?
What it is you guys want to see. If you want me just to kind of just rush through the story and just do side stuff as it comes up. If you want to see me do everything. If this episode ends up being less than 30 minutes, I apologize. Like I said, I completely lost track of the time whenever my mom called me. And I will do my best I can to edit out some of the bigger hiccups that occurred during that. And once again, I also apologize for that cutscene being skipped due to that one. I still don't know what it was that caused that. I don't think it was me recording and playing, because like I said, I streamed for 12 hours Tuesday with minimal interference. But until next time, be sure to hit that subscribe, that like, leave a comment, and hit the notification bell. Good night, good luck, and have fun.